In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of trapezius. Trapezius is very big muscle on back of the body. Where is it? It's this muscle. It's like a rectangular shape. It's very broad muscle. Let's look its origin first. Origin is basically on the axial spine. It's here, occiput, in the middle of cervical spine, thoracic spine, and all the way down to thoracic spine 12. So occiput, all the way down to T12, thoracic spine 12. It's very broad origin, right here, okay? And insertion is a little bit unique. Let's divide trapezius three parts. This is upper part. This is middle part. And let's say this is lower part. This picture has three parts, so it's very convenient, right? The insertion of upper part is on the scapula, especially on the acromion, and lateral part of clavicle. You don't see the clavicle in this picture. However, let's imagine this part attaches on acromion and clavicle. Okay, let's go to middle part. Middle part also attaches on scapula. And this part is spine of scapula. Okay, and the lower part also attaches on the spine of scapula, same as the middle fiber. However, it's very important, this attaches on more on the medial part of the spine of scapula. Let's say here, the medial part of the scapula. This attachment is very, very important to understand movement of scapula. Okay, upper part is on the acromion and clavicle. Middle part is on the spine of scapula. Lower part is also on the spine of scapula, but it's more on the medial part. Okay, now let's look the function of trapezius. Trapezius has something to do with basically the head and neck movement and scapular movement. I'd like to talk about more about scapular movement, so I will quickly explain the movement of head and neck. When trapezius contracts, it does neck extension, side bend, and rotation. Simple, right? Extension, side bend, and rotation. This is very simple movement. Now let's move on to the movement of scapula. Same as the fibers of muscles, I will explain one by one, upper part, middle part, and lower part. What does upper part of trapezius do? Imagine, this is origin of upper part. The basically muscle contracts from insertion towards origin. This is a basic rule of muscle. So what happens when muscle contracts this way, shortens this way? What's gonna happen? Its function is elevation is when you shrink the shoulder, moves scapula up. Okay, and one more movement is that, let's say upper fiber attaches here and it pulls scapula this way. What's gonna happen to scapula? Okay, this is scapula, and what kind of movement does scapula do when upper fiber contracts? Then it does an upward rotation because it pulls scapula this way. This direction creates rotational movement for scapula. this rotation is upward rotation. Upward rotation is very, very important for shoulder movement. Wait a second, I'm talking about scapular movement, right? How come it is important for shoulder movement? Okay, shoulder doesn't accomplish its movement by itself. What does it mean? Shoulder needs to cooperate with movement of scapula. Shoulder joint cannot raise up 180 degrees by shoulder joint itself. Scapula needs to move together. So when scapula doesn't move, shoulder cannot move as well. That's why scapula needs to move freely. That's why this upward rotation is crucial for shoulder movement. Okay? This is the function of upper fiber. Elevation and upward rotation. Good. Now let's move on to middle fiber. Middle fiber is very simple. Its direction fiber is pretty much horizon, right? It pulls scapula this way, right? This movement is adduction of scapula, or it is retraction. Adduction and retraction mean same thing. So it pulls scapula this way. It's like a you close scapula towards thoracic spine. That's it. Very simple, right? Adduction, also known as retraction. Good. Let's move on to lower part. Now, lower part. When lower part contracts, it brings scapula this way. The important thing is insertion of lower part is this part, more on the medial part of scapula. What happens when muscle pulls scapula this way? What kind of movement is happened? It is upward rotation as well. Why? Because it attaches on the more on the medial part. So it's kind of image is scratch scapula this way, then upward rotation happens. Let's say if story. If lower part attaches all the way to the lateral part of the scapula, it might not do upward rotation. It might do depression. However, its insertion is right here, this part, medial part, then this vector creates upward rotation. Remember, upper part also does upward rotation. So, lower part and upper part both do upward rotation. This is very, very important. Again, rotational movement of scapula is crucial for shoulder movement. Now, you can say if trapezius gets tight, it can inhibit shoulder movement. That's why the shoulder girdle muscles, like trapezius or other muscles such as pectoralis minor, serratus anterior, these muscles are very important for scapular movement and, of course, for shoulder movement. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of trapezius. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.